The podcast you are listening to of Holmberg's Morning Sickness is brought to you by my friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Trust me on this one. You've had barbecue before, but you haven't had it this good. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale, ericsfamilybbq.com.
When was the last time you had really good Texas-style barbecue? Eric's Family Barbecue, the way it's supposed to taste. Always delicious, never rushed, and prepared to perfection. Eric's Family Barbecue uses only 100% fresh meat, slowly smoked over mesquite wood until it's juicy and delicious. We all know their brisket is the best, but have you tried their pulled pork, pork ribs, or rib tips? Amazing, and their sides are all house-made. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Make the trip. You won't be sorry. Go to ericsfamilybbq.com for more information.
This man needs medical attention.
Holmberg's Morning Sickness.
The old method of treatment for a person in this condition was to throw him in jail.
Yes.
Just got a text, an email, actually, that said, this is ridiculous. It said, I don't know, I got to look deeper into it, but the headline has my interest, Brady, before we get into the entertainment. FBI raid at NSA employee's home, which means the National Security Advisement. Is that what are they? Something like, I don't know,
whatever.
Agency.
Whatever.
16 million dick pics.
So that's a lot.
NSA, not of his dick, Brady,
oh,
of ours. He got access to the NSA files.
You don't have mine.
There's 16 million dick pics out there. Brady, you might be the only person that's never done it. John G., you've thrown a dick pic around. Come on. Once, you have to. Your wiener's on tape somewhere. The lady friend took a picture of you two doing something and your dick was in it. See? Yep, you've done it.
Not as long as your face isn't in it, it doesn't matter.
That's exactly right. But 16 million pics. 16 million in one person's possession.
I didn't know there were that many dick pics out there.
Which means that that's just a little, the scratch of the surface.
Wow.
He does those, like pictures. And if you look really close, yeah, they're all pixelated little mini dick pics.
If everybody's like me, 16 million, you got each person responsible for 80 to 90,000 dick pics per person. It makes sense that there's probably over 10 trillion dick pics out there somewhere on the planet. Because everybody's lying about it. I've never done it. You've done it.
I don't take pictures of anything.
You take a picture, you think. Come on. Brady hasn't, because he's worried his parents will find it. But once they go, Ansel Adams is going to be in his pants in like a second.
There's someone that has it.
Has your dick pic or has your dick?
Probably the pic. Dr. Lynn.
There's a dick pic out there?
Well, on that video.
Do they take pictures?
I mean, they had that video where they're pulling out the stent. That was on camera.
Was it a video or is it just, were they taping or was it just a camera? I don't think they're actually running film. It's just,
yeah, I think he's talking like screenshots
the
and stuff.
Where you see the, you can see the.
Yeah, they're not running a tape so they can watch later.
It's a shadow. It's like X-ray.
I hope. He's like, we'll save that for, we'll watch that at home on Friday.
Yeah, he watches it all the time.
Yeah, I bet. All right. Well, interesting. 16 million in one
person. That's a lot.
Home. Man. That's pretty good. I'm enjoying that.
One's too many.
One's too many for each person to have someone else's dick.
That's what I'm saying, sure.
Anthony Weiner responsible for a million of them.
Does this look infected? There's tons of reasons to take pictures of it. Joke. Oops. What you doing?
At the weddings when they leave those cameras on tables and everything.
Oh, you know,
everybody's taking a picture of their dicks. Absolutely. Go develop this. I've been accused for years at my friend Mark Stebbings that somebody took one of those disposable cameras and shot it down there.
And is it?
It is not.
Okay.
Because the picture they showed me, there's a mole. I'm like, there is no mole there. I do not have. Now, maybe the small white protrusion is my penis, but that mole is a dead giveaway. Loads of like massive pubes and stuff. I'm like, that's not
like
me.
It's like Porky's.
It was.
There was a mole.
There was a mole.
That's
right.
Whacker.
It's the same as Porky's. Mine's not on the penis, but it's on the skin and you can see it through the hair. I'm like, that's not mine. Plus, I think the pants were blue and I wore black pants to that wedding. So take that, Stebbings. We all have our theories on who it is, but. And Stebbings' mom's like, whoever it is, it's not impressive. And I'm like, well, that's not for argument, ma'am.
No
judgment.
Definitely
not mine.
Now it could be mine. You're building a case. Anyway, it's time now for the entertainment drill. It's brought to you by our friends at ReactDefense.com, the home of tactical black self-defense training, which I hope to get back to ASAP. They're the ones who helped me get my own arm back to normal when I had my shoulder stuff going on. And they helped me by just basically building a plan around what I can do with my busted up body. And now I've got this hip situation where, you know what, we worked around it for a while. Now that it's fixed, I'm sure I'll be back to new before you know it. Doing the PT is the most important part of recovery in any type of injury, accident or surgery or anything you've got going on. And these people get you in shape. Again, it's the crawl, walk, run. They're not a physical therapy place. But if you come in and say, I can't do this, I can't do that, they're going to find ways to make it so you can do the stuff that gets you to the next step. Without, you know, any problems. The street doesn't care what you can and can't do. Bad guys do not care that you just had a surgery or that you're a little weaker on one side than the other. That's what's so great about Tactical Black. It teaches you your best way to protect yourself and the people you care about at all times. And it's eye-opening stuff. You don't really realize what you can do in the current condition you're in today. You can be in terrible shape. You can be weak today. Right now, sitting here with this cane, I still feel good. Because I know I got a weapon in one hand at this point that's also keeping me up, and I got to protect myself more than ever. I'm a sitting duck. Again, you never see the lion going after the healthy gazelle. You see it going after the weak one. Don't be the weak one. That's basically what this is. Teach yourself to be a sheepdog and not a sheep, and they'll do that for you. ReactDefense.com. It's the home of Tactical Black Phoenix, Glendale, Chandler, Brady. Entertain me.
Yesterday was a rough day for R. Kelly. Found guilty on every account.
All of them.
Even showing up at court. Guilty.
Just being guilty.
He's looking at decades in prison.
Yeah.
And that's just New York. Because he has to go to trial in Chicago.
He's got to do another one.
And what's the other city?
Is Minnesota. Atlanta? Oh, Minnesota.
Yeah.
I this is how I know that R. Kelly did it. And everyone knows it. Like, there is no black and white division on the R. Kelly case. Black people all think he, white people all think. There's no race divide on R. Kelly. You get a few outliers that'll scream and yell that he's a genius and whatever. O.J. Simpson, that was a race divide. Nobody wants to see R. Kelly go free as some sort of a victory for their side. They all know, okay, we'd like to see R. Kelly locked up. And yesterday was a victorious day for humanity. And I think even Gayle King, when she interviewed him a few years ago, remember, and he lost his mind on Gayle King, yeah. Oprah's friend. It's like, well, wait a minute now. And Gayle sat back like, yeah.
How about sitting through that trial and all the witnesses that came up? And,
yeah.
So you married Aaliyah when she was 15.
Right.
I think they're saying that wedding. I heard that they can actually go back on that now, too.
Oh, yeah. They can get him for everything. I mean, everybody on the jury. I mean, even when the foreman, if you reach a decision, yes, Your Honor, on all counts, this did it here. This man did it. He, this mother is guilty. All right, you heard him, R. Kelly. Robert. So he's got to go to jail for a long time, and that's great. Now, the only argument going back to the race thing is John Hinckley got out for trying to shoot the president. So yeah. I think he should be in jail forever, too, as at least a concession. But R. Kelly, nobody likes him. I never understood his music anyway. I Believe I Could Fly is a good song.
Well, that's story one that's like 45 minutes
trapped
for the first
in the
half.
Closet.
Yeah,
he's got
some of the lyrics on that are amazing.
They're hilarious, but it's not art. It's just a dope.
He sings about someone farted.
Yeah, then someone farted. It was stupid, and he's got a few of those. It's like I don't get the Kanye West thing outside of a couple of songs, and I don't get the R. Kelly thing. But he got labeled a genius so fast that he started
Kanye,
to do everyone
at all. I just don't get Kanye at all.
There's not a lot for me to get. Like, there's a couple of songs. You're like, that's okay. He's a genius. I'm like, I think he says that.
Demi Lovato has a show on the Peacock called Unidentified with Demi Lovato. And she talks about the beautiful alien experience she had in Joshua Tree National Forest.
She was abducted?
She went out into the desert and she basically saw this blue orb. That was about 50 feet away.
It's a bucket of Crisco. She couldn't keep her hands off.
It's kind of floating above the ground. It's like 10 or 15 feet, and it was kind of keeping its distance from me, she's right. saying.
I would, too.
Yeah, everybody's trying to keep their distance from you. You're insane.
Will Smith was being interviewed by GQ, and it's the cover story. And he talked about he and Jada and their relationship has evolved past monogamy. Like, they've worked
they
it out a while.
With each other.
Yeah, they're allowed to have their freedoms. They're always basically committed to each other.
Right. But they can bang other people, and the other one can't.
And he says it basically came from Jada's side originally. She's like, she never wanted to be exclusive necessarily in the marriage.
Interesting.
But then he talked about when, I think it was a little over a year ago, when she had that one of, who was it, Willow's or one of the kids' friends, that young rapper. She had the
affair with him. Started humping that guy.
Yeah, and he kind of, Will kind of confirmed me. He's like, the reason I didn't really talk about that, I had my own little thing going on I'm not going to get into.
Yeah, it's called his money.
I'm not going to open up that can of worms.
Right, well, there's his money, and then there's also the, I don't want to have to get into this back and forth because I was doing it too. We both knew.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that. People that do, like the guy from Silicon Valley that said, he got married and he knew about a month in, he goes, this isn't going to work for me, but I still want to be with you. And he told his wife, we need to be polyamorous. I need to be allowed to do this. And she flipped out at first, and then she's like, but he's telling me at least, you know?
Good news for Disney.
Weird, but go get him.
Robbie Knievel, Evel Knievel's son, sued Disney over Toy Story 4 because they had a character in there, Duke Kaboom.
Yeah. Michael Keaton.
Court case was dismissed.
Really?
Yeah.
Because Duke Kaboom and Robbie Knievel not the same. By the way, Robbie Knievel, Evel Knievel should sue you. You never did anything. You stole your dad's
ass. He's on that leaner bike, that light bike that can fly.
Yeah. Duke Kaboom was Michael Keaton, right? Am I right? I'm pretty sure that's right.
It could be.
I think. Maybe not.
Your boy Martin Cove got booted off of Dancing with the Stars.
He's 90. Who was it? Duke Kaboom was the Ken doll.
Keanu
was Duke Kaboom.
Duke Kaboom. Michael Keaton was the Ken doll.
That's right. That's right.
And then if you haven't seen it yet, David Letterman crashed the Brooklyn Nets press conference.
Yeah, pretty solid.
Asked a couple of questions to KD.
Why do they call you KD?
Mm-hmm.
To Kevin Durant. And he answered it because Kevin Durant is humorless.
And what do you plan on? Yeah. What kind of effort do you plan on giving this
year? What kind of percentage do you plan on giving this year? 85, 95, 100, or 110%? And he answered it.
There were, some guy did a list of the rock bands who have been used in Jeopardy episodes. Like, I'll give you an example. Despite losing an arm, Rick Allen continues to drum for this hard rock group.
Yeah, Def Leppard.
Yep. Sadly, on January 8th, 1994, this group played its last ever U.S. show in its hometown of Seattle.
Nirvana.
I didn't know this one. Aerosmith got the song Walk This Way from a line in this movie.
I think I do know that. I want to say Gentlemen Prefer Blondes, but it's not that one. It's a Marilyn Monroe movie, isn't it?
What is Young Frankenstein?
Oh, really? Oh, Walk This Way. Oh, that's right. Oh, that's great. Wow. I didn't know that. I like that one. Good stuff. All right. Well, there you go. Let's get the heck out of here. I'm going to go pop some pills. Go to sleep until tomorrow.
Deuce.
No, I won't deuce till tomorrow. I got to shower tomorrow.
You
do plenty for both of us.
I will.
Yeah. You got to go to break? Oh, really? Oh, John's now you're doing
time.
It too? Jesus Christ. Crying out loud. No kidding. All right. I will. Jeez, we're late. This is everybody's fault.
I thought he was going to kill you. He did the finger across the throat.
Started the throat slash. All right, we're done. Larry's coming up next. Have yourselves a great day. We'll see you tomorrow right here in the Morning Sickness. So long.
98. Oh, my gosh.
98.
Shut the front door.
You've been listening to Holmberg's Morning Sickness podcast, brought to you by our friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet Mesquite. Repeat, ericsfamilybbq.com.